deal with perimeter and circumference. So let's take a look at this first one. We see the area of a square is 64 square feet, and we want to find the square's perimeter. Well, in order to find perimeter, we need to know side lengths. So let's draw a picture. So we have a square, and we know that the area is 64 square feet. Well, how do we find area of a square? Remember, area of a square is just one side length raised to the second power. And so if we know that the area was 64, we can find one side length by solving that equation. So we'll undo that square with a square root, and we get that one side length is equal to 8. And so now each of these sides is 8. And so now the perimeter comes pretty quickly. Remember, the perimeter is the sum of all of the sides. There are 4 sides, and all the sides are the same, so we could just say the perimeter is 4 times 8. In this case, that would be 32 feet. Let's try another problem. Here we have the area of a circle is 81 pi square feet. What is the circle's circumference? So first off, in order to find circumference, remember circumference is either pi times diameter or pi times 2 times r. So we need either the diameter or the radius. So now let's draw a picture. We know we have a circle, and we know its area. So we have a circle, and we know that the area is 81 pi. So we'll have to reverse engineer that area. Remember, the area of a circle, the formula, is pi times r squared. And if the area was 81 pi, we'll solve the equation 81 pi equals pi times r squared. Now this looks more complicated than it might be. On both sides of the equation we have pi. And remember, pi is just a number. And so that means we can divide both sides of the equation by pi. And that leaves us with 81, because pi divided by pi is 1. Pi divided by pi is 1. So therefore, 81 is equal to r squared. And now this looks very similar to the problem that we just solved with the square. We want to find the radius, so we'll take the square root of 81, and so that gives us a radius of 9 feet. Now coming back to our circumference, we can pick either of these two formulas. Since I already have the radius, I'll use this formula. And I know that the circumference is pi times 2 times the radius, which was 9. And then we can clean that up. 2 times 9 is 18. So we would say that the circumference is 18 pi feet. Now that would be an exact answer, an answer expressed in terms of pi. If we wanted to, we could multiply 18 times pi, or 18 times 3.14, to give an approximate answer. But if you were asked for an exact answer, you would leave it as 18 pi feet. Let's try one more. Minus 3. I believe that's fixed on your note sheet. So it should be 2x minus 3. Now, we know the perimeter. Right, the perimeter is given to us as 39 feet. So remember, to find the perimeter of a triangle, the perimeter was side plus side plus side. So all three sides added together. We have information only about two sides. However, remember that these congruence marks indicate that if this side is 3x plus 5, then this side is also 3x plus 5. And so now we have all the information about three sides. In order to find the length of one of those sides, we need to figure out what x is. So let's plug this information into our perimeter formula. I see that the perimeter, that was 39, and that equals one side, let's say 3x plus 5 plus another side plus this third side. So now we need to solve this equation, solve it for x. First, I see I've got 3x, 3x, and 2x. Together, that makes 8x. Then I have plus 5, plus another 5 makes 10, minus 3. 10 minus 3 is plus 7. Oops, wanted blue. And that equals 39. Now we'll solve that equation. We'll subtract 7 from both sides. And then divide both sides by 8. So awesome, we get that x is equal to 4. But we're not yet done. Remember, let's answer the question that's asked. We're asked to find the length of each side. So we'll have to substitute x back in. So for this side, let's say, we'd say 3 times 4 plus 5. That'll give us one side length, so 12 plus 5 makes 17. I know because these congruence marks that this side is also 17. And then this last side, 2x minus 3, so 2 times the quantity 4 minus 3. 2 times 4 is 8 minus 3. That gives us a side length of 5. Now we see that we were working in feet, and so we'll have to go back in and say each of these is 17 feet, 17 feet, and 5 feet.